Hello guys, it's me
and me.
My friends.
And me.
And we are here in the actual KiwiCo, and we are about to test this giant spinner.
Huge! It's 10 feet tall!
Guys, ready? Let's go.
Go for it.
All right, 3, 2, 1. All right.
Here at KiwiCo, we love taking on challenges. Usually we do that when we're designing our crates, but earlier today I was playing with our spin art machine and I couldn't stop thinking about what it would be like if I could be inside the machine with the paint flying everywhere. So then of course I'm thinking, how could I make this big enough so that I could be inside of it? How could I make a room-sized spin art machine? This is gonna be a really big build, so I'm gonna need some help.
Have you played with the spin art machine before?
I have, it is a ton of fun.
It's super fun. I'm thinking, what if we made a giant version that we could stand inside of?
That would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
What were you thinking of building?
I'm not sure on the design yet, but I'm thinking it definitely needs to spin, just like this one, and it needs to fling paint everywhere.
And what if we made it so that we could change the speed of it so we could do like some cool patterns on the walls, maybe some colors?
That would be really cool. That's a good up level. See like how it reacts when it's slow versus fast. We're gonna need something that throws paint not just on the floor, but on the walls.
Sounds good, let's get to work.
So first thought is if we were to just make the spin art machine big, we would just have a giant rotating platform. We could have paint buckets hanging above it and then the paint dripping down. But the walls would end up just having like a line of rainbow paint, you know? I'm really trying to get drenched in paint.
Yeah, if we were to just take a spinning platform and mount a few 45 degree angled cups, then we could sort of harness the centripetal effect to be able to fling the paint onto the walls.
Cool, I like that. This is way easier than this one. Let's do this.
To start, I'm going to cut out some holes so that I can place and glue in these cups. That way they sit at a slight angle, so when this machine gets spinning, the momentum should fling the paint all over.
So this is our first prototype to try and build a machine that can cover an entire room with paint. We've got a bunch of cups filled with water for now, paint later. They're all at an angle and they're on this spinny stool.
Yeah, all we gotta do to get this thing working is pull on this rope here and hopefully all this water will go flying.
Yeah, let's see if we can make a splash.
Let's do it. All right, 3, 2, 1.
Nice. Oh, there we go. The first prototype looked really promising. To scale this up into something that can cover an entire room in paint, we'll need 3 tiers holding about a gallon of paint each. As the platforms spin, the paint will fly out, but gravity will pull it down. To make sure that everyone in the splash zone will get appropriately soaked in paint, we need to make this tall. I'm thinking 10 feet tall.
So that's gonna go on the floor?
Yeah, it's gonna go on the floor. Right now, I'm attaching all of these connectors to our PVC pieces, and I'm adding a little bit of epoxy, which is like a super, super strong glue. The connectors actually fit on really well, but we're gonna be spinning this really fast, so we wanna make sure that it's not going anywhere. All right. Yeah. Cool, I think it looks good.
Yeah.
Sweet.
It's done! Let's go!
Check out our giant paint explosion machine! Our machine is comprised of 3 platforms, each supporting a ton of paint, and of course, organized in rainbow order. Everything is attached to this PVC pipe, and inside of this PVC pipe is a smaller, thinner pipe for it to rotate around. And of course, in order to support the entire thing and keep it steady, we've got about 200 pounds weighing this entire thing down.
And the system we're using to power this thing is this pulley system. It uses friction to hold around the pole,
Yanai and I will pull this rope, which will rotate this entire assembly, and we can pull faster and faster or slower and slower and see how that affects the splatter pattern. And hopefully we're gonna get messy. We've had a few great prototypes with this, but all of those prototypes have been using water. Paint is thicker, and we're just not exactly sure how it's going to affect the splatter or how far this is gonna go. So this is a true experiment for all of us.
And of course, we wanna invite some friends to come join in on this.
All right, let's call the kids.
Did they even know what they're doing?
No.
All right, let's do it.
That was fun.
You wanna get suited up?
Yeah.
I feel very hot.
Come on in.
Does it like spin around?
Is this supposed to spin around and soak us all in paint?
What makes you think that?
I have no idea.
Yeah, you got it. This is a giant spin art machine. It'll spin around.
I knew it!
Yeah. All right, are you ready to get messy?
Yeah!
Kind of.
Hello guys, it's me
and me.
My friends.
And me.
And we are here in the actual KiwiCo, and we are about to test this giant spinner. We're not exactly sure what's gonna happen yet.
I think we're gonna
things are gonna get messy. This is cool. You guys ready?
Yeah!
Okay guys, we're about to start. Guys, ready? Let's go.
Okay, let's all line up over here against this wall.
This is the safe zone.
Yeah, this is the safe zone.
So we're gonna start spinning this, and what do you think is gonna happen?
I'm gonna be dirty.
I think I'm gonna get paint in my mouth.
Paint in your mouth? Gross! We're gonna start pulling it slowly, and we're gonna go faster and faster and faster, and watch, and let's see if we can see how the paint flies out differently when we're pulling slowly versus when we're pulling quickly.
Okay.
Sound good?
Ready?
Okay, so can you guys strike a pose? So that we get a cool silhouette, maybe. And try to stay still while it's going.
Dude, I'm so scared.
Let's do it.
You guys, have you ever done this before? No! This is for
the first time.
This is
gonna
be crazy. Go for it. All right,
three, two, one.
Slow and then fast. All right.
I didn't really think it would come in dots. I thought it would be like a line stuck together.
Oh, but it was more like splatter.
Yeah.
So Camila, earlier we were talking about where the different colors were gonna end up. Do you wanna look around the room and see what ended up happening?
The purples and the blues ended up low. And then as you go up, it gets warmer and warmer. So the oranges and the reds were on the top.
Yeah, so the orange and the reds were on top in the machine, and then they also ended up on top on the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So as our machine spins faster and faster, we see more paint fly out, and that's thanks to the centrifugal effect. It fans out farther and farther, eventually covering the floor and even the walls. This all happens because the paint is being pushed outward by the spinning motion. The faster it spins, the stronger the force pushing it outward, causing it to spread further away from the center, so the higher the speed, the bigger the splatter. Do you guys all feel like a work of art?
Yeah!
You look like it! Okay, we've done it! Giant success for our giant spin art machine! Woo! Thanks for watching! Come see
see us next time. Subscribe to our channel for more cool builds like this one.
Yahoo! Like and subscribe, guys. Remember to do that and also ring the bell.
I couldn't have said it better.
Oh no. The camera got messed up, kinda.